Are you ready for a new Dutch journey? I am Martijn and your host in and around
Eindhoven-Jackson!
It was Duke Hendrik I of Brabant who granted city rights to Eindhoven in 1232. Today, Eindhoven is the fifth largest city in the Netherlands, located in the south of the country and well known as the city of innovation. Over 130 years ago, Philips brought lights to Eindhoven. The company transformed the city into a vibrant industrial success story. The city is in a constant flow of new developments in the fields of creativity, innovation, technology, design and knowledge.
In this Eindhoven Travel Guide, I show you the best attractions, places to shop and stay, this sky bar and everything in between. I don't like to ask, but please like and subscribe. That's the only way to grow on YouTube and make new content in the future. Thank you. From Amsterdam, you can be in Eindhoven in just over an hour by train. And you arrive here at this beautiful and unique building, the Central Station. It's built in 1956 and it has often been claimed that it bears similarities with a transistor radio of that time. But the funny thing is that such a radio never existed. Another way to arrive is by plane on Eindhoven Airport with direct connections from all over Europe. I'm here in the downtown area in Emma District. Let's start to explore the center of Eindhoven. Here on the 18th September Square, where you find the Blob and the Philips Light Tower. The Blob is a futuristic building designed by an Italian architect. It's 25 meters high and covered in steel and glass. And it stands shoulder to shoulder to the Philips Light Tower.
In this light tower, the Lichttoren, Philips' light bulbs were tested for live hours. This made the iconic building light up 24 hours a day. This area is also great for shopping. You will find all the big brands in this neighborhood. In a moment, you see the best place for a drink and this cool museum.
But first, we are near the Catharinakerk, an impressive church in the city center. This is not the first church on this place because the old one became too small, and that's the reason they built a new one between 1861 and 1867. The price for the construction in these days was 126,000 euros. At this time, that's nothing. I think you get one or maybe two parking spots in Amsterdam for that at the moment. And in 1972, it became a national monument. From here, you are near the Stratum's Eind. This is a street with 52 bars. Actually, it's the street with the most bars in the Netherlands. Another place to visit is De Kleine Berg. This is more a place to socialize with a drink. Eindhoven is the city of light, so it's not strange that you can visit a real light experience here. It's called motion. Let light move and people do exactly the same. That's what they say. This is just a nice but also weird experience because light is just following you. Hi Fleur.
Hi.
Hello. Why should you visit this museum?
Well, there are a lot of museums in Eindhoven, but this is a one-of-a-kind museum. It's all about light, and you can be part of the light art instead of just looking at it. And that's the fun part to visit motion.
This is certainly a good place if you want to give your life some color. Only by pushing this button you can change it to all the colors you want. For my stay here, I booked a room in the Pullman Eindhoven Cocagne Hotel. For me, it's easy to navigate around town from here because it's in the city center and close to the Central Station, with spa and gym facilities and a parking area for guests. If you want to pay attention to a better environment, this hotel is a good choice because it has a Green Key Gold label. It's an international quality mark for sustainable companies. And don't forget the Brabantse gemoedelijkheid. This is also a Dutch course, this video for you. It means the Brabantse geniality with a 5-star service.
Just a shot away from the corner where I used to play with my friends as a kid. I saw a man with a pulled up collar playing banjo with an invisible stick singing.
And yes, I have to thank some Instagram friends. For example, Kasper, Eliane, Nout and Timo for their advice to visit this place, the downtown Gourmet Market. It's a food market gathering around 20 shops together under one roof. And it goes from a variety of street foods to high cuisine and dishes from all over the world. And I recommend you, when you visit this place in the spring or summer, to sit outside on the terrace. In Spanish I say bon provecho, in Dutch eet smakelijk. This food looks delicious. If you want to see some industrial heritage, then you have to visit Strijp S. In the past, this was the Forbidden City, because it was only accessible to Philips employees. Today, the old factories are transformed into cool shops and nice food spots. Just like the meatpacking district in New York. And I'm with Björn. Hi Björn, welcome to Martijn Around the World. What are you making right here at Intelligentsia Taste Rooms?
Yeah, of course we are really famous about our homemade artisanal ice cream, but we're also making chocolates, pastry and afternoon tea.
And you are top 5 listed in the Netherlands with the best ice cream restaurants, I believe.
We are now visiting one of the top 5 best ice cream parlors of the Netherlands, but we also did win the Golden Ice Cream Competition last year, so we are still Dutch champion.
It must be a tasty competition then, yeah. And what's your key to success?
I think the sharing of love, but also the translation of the concept into our products with food design or with technology, I think that's making the difference with the rest of the ice cream parlors of the Netherlands.
Besides Strijp S, you can also visit Strijp R, or Air, just another part of this neighborhood. This area is home to many designers here in Eindhoven. For example, Piet Hein Eek. This is his store. And Eindhoven is the design capital of the Netherlands for many years.
The origins go back to the days when Philips' needs for industrial designers surged. Design Academy, a first in the Netherlands, was founded in 1955. The creative people who were brought to Eindhoven by Philips required deeper visibility. This then led to the well-known Dutch Design Week, the largest design event in Northern Europe, with work and concepts from more than 2,600 designers.
In a moment you know where you can find the best street art here in town. But first I show you the Van Abbe Museum. Not Abba Museum, Van Abbe Museum.
This museum was founded in 1936 and is one of the most prestigious museums for modern art, with an international collection of more than 2,700 works, including work by Dijkstra, Mondrian and Pablo Picasso. The original building was renovated and extended in 2003. Please check the link in the text below to book your tickets.
I told you this before, Dutch cities are not that big and the best way to see a lot is to walk. Also here to the Woensel West neighborhood. In the past this area used to be known for its problems like prostitution and crime. So when you ask me, Martijn, where are you taking me today? I'm taking you to a neighborhood that has changed over the years, to a vibrant and creative part with the best street art in town. Of course I try to show you some unique places in Eindhoven, and this is certainly one of them. One of my favorites, a rooftop bar with an amazing view around town, the Veen Sky Bar. I keep telling myself it will happen eventually. Give a thumbs up, thank you so much, when you like this video. And if you don't want to miss any other episodes, just subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's totally free and it enriches your view on the whole world. Tot ziens. Ciao. Hasta luego.